We are looking at question 61, and it's asking us to graph the solution set of a system of inequalities or indicate that the system has no solution. So looking at my given inequalities, the first thing I know I want to do to be able to graph these is to label them so I know which one I'm working with, and then put them in to slope-intercept form. And slope-intercept form is when you have y is equal to mx plus b, where b is your y-intercept and m is your slope. So let's go ahead and let's start working with our first equation. 2x minus y is less than or equal to negative 6, and let's get this into slope-intercept by subtracting both sides by 2x, so we can isolate our y. This is going to get us negative y is less than or equal to negative 2x minus 6. Divide both sides by negative 1 to get rid of that negative 1 coefficient. And when you ever divide an inequality by a negative, you have to flip the sign, or else you will mess up your entire work. Flip that sign, do not forget. So when you flip it, you're going to get y is greater than or equal to positive 2x plus 6 as your first inequality. Now let's do the same thing for our second inequality. Our second one is x plus 2y is greater than or equal to negative 2. Again, isolate that y. We're going to get 2y is greater than or equal to negative x minus 2. Divide both sides by that 2 coefficient and get rid of it. You will get y is greater than or equal to negative 1 half x minus 1 as your second inequality. So now that we have these in our slope-intercept form, let's go ahead and start by graphing the first one. Y is greater than or equal to 2x plus 6. So we know that it starts at the y-intercept at positive 6, and the slope is 2x, meaning rise 2 over 1. And it's a positive slope, so from left to right, it'll be going up towards the right. So let's go up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, and running in the left direction, you're going to go down 2 over 1, down 2 over 1 until you complete your entire line. Now that we have all the plots drawn out, we're going to go ahead and draw our line. And remember that when you have inequalities, if it's less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, it's going to be a solid line. If it's just greater than or less than, it's going to be a dashed line. So let's go ahead and draw a solid line through our points. So now that we have the solid line put down, I'm going to go ahead and do the origin test, so that we can determine where on the graph we are going to shade for our first inequality. So for our origin test, or as my professor liked to call it, the 0, 0 test, what you do is you plug the point 0, 0, 0, 0 into your inequality and you solve or simplify. And then, judging off of your simplified inequality, if that statement is true, then you shade the entire region of graph where the point 0, 0 lays. So if the statement is false, again, then shade the region of the graph where the point 0, 0 does not lay. Now, when you have more than one inequality, then you are going to keep the overlaying regions. So let's go ahead and let's follow these steps and plug in 0, 0 into our first inequality. So when you do that, you're going to get 0 is greater than or equal to 2 times 0 plus 6. This will give you the statement 0 is greater than or equal to 6. We know that 0 is not greater than 6. So that is a false statement, meaning you are going to shade the entire region of the graph where the point 0, 0 does not lay. Meaning 0, 0 is here and it's false, so you are going to shade right here for your first inequality. Sorry if my shading's outside the lines, I apologize. And then we're gonna follow the same steps for our second inequality. We're gonna go and graph it, and our y-intercept's negative 1, so that's where we will start. And our slope is negative 1 half, meaning it's gonna be dropping to the right when you're leading from left to right, and you're gonna rise 1 and go over 2. So we're gonna rise 1, go over 2, drop 1, go over 2, you're going to repeat the process so you get an entire plotted line. So when we do that, we get a plotted line. Let's go ahead and put a line through it, and since it is, again, a greater than or equal to line, it's going to be a solid line. So let's go ahead and draw that solid line. So now that we have that graph, we're going to go ahead and follow the same principle with the origin test for our second inequality. We're going to plug the point 0, 0 into it, which will give us the inequality that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 1 half times 0 minus 1. And that will simplify down to negative 2, 0 is greater than or equal to negative 1. And we know that this is a true statement because 0 is greater than negative 1. So now that the statement is true, we know that we're going to shade where the point 0, 0 lays for this inequality. So this means we're going to shade everywhere it lays, so it's only above the inequality. Let's go ahead and shade that in. Let's try not to mess it up terribly. So now that we have it shaded in, looking at our origin test rules, if you have more than one inequality, you keep the overlaying regions, meaning we are going to keep this region right here of our graph shaded because it satisfies both of our inequalities, meaning for the first inequality, you have only the portion where it is shaded in the 0, 0 test where it's false. And for our second inequality, you have it only shaded where it's true for that test, because if it was shaded down here below our second inequality, then that would produce a false statement. That is not what we got from our test, which is why we have to keep this shaded region. So when we erase the other shaded regions right here and here, you are going to get this graph as your final answer. And again, comment below if you have any questions and we can further explain and answer your questions for you. Thank you for watching.